beginning of the Sabbath will be a little bit different. I'm glad that we can do that together with Mr. Rosen here. Also, just for you to know, if you don't recognize me because of the mask, I'm Chaplain Jake here, and I will also introducing Mr. Rosen. I will read a parsha with you. It's a parsha for today. It's 15 Adar, year 5782, and in our modern calendar, it's a March 18, and it's based on Leviticus chapter 8, and goes like this. And he brought near the second ram, the ram of the investiture, and Aaron and his son leaned their head upon the ram's head. That means here what they did, Moses brought the second ram, and Aaron and his sons laid their hands on the ram. It was dedicated for this purpose. Verse 23, and he slaughtered it, and Moses took some of its blood and placed it on the cartilage of the Aaron's right ear, on the thumb of his right hand, and on the big toe of his right foot. And he brought Aaron's sons forward, and Moses placed some of the blood on the cartilage of their right ears, on the thumb of their right hand, and on the big toes of their right feet. And Moses dashed the blood on the altar around. And he took the fat, the tail, all the fat which was on the innards, the diaphragm of the liver, the two kidneys together with their fat, and the right thigh, out of the basket of unleavened bread that was before the Lord. He took one loaf of unleavened bread and one loaf of oily bread and one wafer. He placed them on the top of the fats and the right thigh. All that he placed it on Aaron's palm and on his son's palm, and on the and he waved them as waving before the Lord. And Moses took them from their hands and made them going up in smoke on the altar along with the burnt offering. They were investiture offering as a pleasing fragrance, a fire offering to the Lord. And Moses took the breast and waved it as a wave in front of the Lord. It belonged to Moses as a portion from the ram of the investitures, and Lord had, as Lord commanded to Moses. I'm glad we have this partial reading, because it's telling us how God is organizing, very organizing, and he's very intentful for what he's planning to do. And he's ordering Moses to do certain things in order to prepare the tabernacle or the shul, synagogue in a desert. And I'm glad that we can see how God is very unique in a context of the organization, and very peculiar. There is a small details here that are very important for us to even think about. And I'm glad that he bring this to us as information for us to think about the meaning of this. And right now, as we finish in reading Parsha, it's about time for us to enjoy Mr. Rosen quality of playing, and hopefully maybe we can see him, hear him singing. I don't know, but maybe he will enjoy that. We will enjoy that also. Now sit tight, and Mr. Rosen will bless us with a playing piano and good old nice three songs that are very Purim dedicated, also with other songs that he planning to share with us. Now sit tight and let's enjoy it.
Thank you. Shalom Aleichem. Mashiach, the Messiah, is coming.
Thank you. Oh. Our kisses would
what kind of capacity of lungs and voice we have here. That's our melody. Mr. Rosen, thank you very much for being here with us. Thank you for using your gift to come.
I have to play a few anthems right now to end the program.
Okay, now we are finishing and we will let Mr. Rosen do whatever he's planning with us. Thank you very much and listen to Mr. Rosen.
Hatikva, the Israeli national anthem.
Okay.